Okay, class, this is a 7.5 minute quadrangle that covers the Corvallis area. Again, remembering that a 7.5 minute quadrangle covers a lot less than a degree, we see that latitude and longitude are marked at each corner of the map in full. Corvallis is, of course, north latitude and west longitude. We can also measure distances on a map using a ruler and the bar scale, which is down here at the bottom of the map area. Let's say, for example, that we want to measure how wide the OSU campus is in an east-west direction. The OSU campus is here in this part of Corvallis. The way we would measure a distance on the map is we would just take our ruler, measure a distance in inches on the map area, and then use the bar scale to convert inches on the map to miles in the real world. I'm laying my ruler along the distance that I want to measure. I find that the Corvallis campus is about 1.5 inches wide. Now, the distance you measure with your ruler may be different depending on the level of zoom or magnification that you're viewing the map at. But as you zoom in and out on the map area, your bar scale is zooming in and out with the map as well, so it always retains the same proportions to the map itself. We've measured our distance. I got 1.5 inches. I'm going to bring my ruler down to the bar scale and measure how much, or use the bar scale to convert the inches I measured to miles on the ground. Now notice that the bar scale has its zero point here in the middle. We have 1 mile to the right of the zero point, 1 mile to the left of the zero point, but to the left that mile is divided into tenths. So 1.5 inches starting here, measuring across, that's 1.5 inches, and we find that 1.5 inches on the map at the level I am viewing it at corresponds to 1.8 miles in the real world. 1 mile, 1.1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1.8 miles.